Hello again and welcome back to the second part of the Kids and Pandemic video. I'm Jennifer Merchant from Smart Medical Buyer and this video is a follow-up to the video where I discuss the issues that your kid is probably facing or may face in the near future due to the effects of the pandemic. If you haven't seen that video yet, I would suggest you see that video to get a broader understanding of what our kids are facing and how we can keep them sane post-pandemic. Hi, welcome back. A quick recap of our last video. We discussed how the pandemic has created an environment which has hampered our kids' growth and can result in these possible issues. Social isolation, routine changes, anthropophobia, physical health issues, mental health issues. Now, we do not need to go into the details of each of these issues separately as most of them are a combination of two or more. Instead, I am going to talk about the holistic pointers that are going to help our children steer clear from all the negativity and get back to the world as soon as it resumes. One important side note for us first. We, the parents, need to take the responsibility to put in all the time that is required from here on. If you're not ready, then none of what I'm going to say is going to matter at all. But the fact that you are watching this video makes me believe that you are ready for this.
First,
clear and positive communication from parents to kids. No matter what is happening in our lives, our kids have a way of picking it up, especially when they are home with us all day. Whether you're struggling with money or your relationship itself, they need to know that no matter what, their world is safe and secure with and around you. Excessive anger and argumentation inside the house are a strict no-no for this. Continuous channel rambling, fights between parents are examples of what can ruin your child's health. Second, family and health first. This is a great time to imbibe the feelings of fun being together with your kids. Offer them to eat food together, cook together, watch movies. Make the home a space where they can express themselves freely without having to apologize for being kids. Third, and my favorite, learn and teach. A year is a long time to stay at home, but it would be a disaster for our kids if they do not grow beyond the school curriculum during this period. In fact, we get the time to teach the children things that were impossible to do during normal school routines. These may be technical things, simple like cooking, cleaning, banking, paying bills. They're already moving into the digital world so fast. So it will help them become complete adults if they knew basic computer tools like Photoshop, social media management, or digital marketing. Just don't fall for the ads that are promising to make your 12-year-old the next Elon Musk. At schools, kids learn a lot by exchanging information with their peers, which means asking them and transferring information. At home, however, this information is mostly one way. We push what we know to our kids, but hardly want to learn anything from them. Break that chain. Offer to learn from your kids as well. Be it something about computers, video games, or their PS, or anything new around the world. Knowledge is best when shared both ways. And if we open up to our kids about learning, we will have a more respectful and knowledgeable group of kids around us. Another side note, do not become clingy to our kids. Allow them the space and time to make up their own minds. Otherwise, every offer we make to spend time with them will be rejected by them. There is a fine balance that we adults need to understand and respect. Fourth, healthy diet and exercise. While on normal days, our kids can shake off their junk food because of their hectic physical schedules. But that luxury is gone now. And if you do not change their diet and physical habits to match with this change, it can have serious repercussions. Though it will not be easy to change them from junk food to salads overnight. Fifth, prepare for normalcy. This might be the most difficult and least understood point of what we discussed today. We need to understand that most of these kids will have to rewire their brains when they meet new people and possibly even relearn some of the things they already knew. The first thing to remember is do not force them into anything. There might be a marked hesitancy amongst them to go out and interact with new people. Just give them slight nudges and let them pick up things their way. Go out to restaurants and public places with them and interact with people in a manner that you wish to see them interacting with. Neither should they be scared of people, nor should they believe that COVID-19 does not exist anymore. Keeping this balance can decide between a third wave or none. So that's for now. These are some of the points which I think can reduce the impact of the pandemic on the health of your children. If you like this video, please press like. If you wish to subscribe, press the subscribe button. And if you have any questions, please do comment below. I'll be glad to reply to them.